You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give you a glimpse of our country's diversity. Land of varied cultures and different religions, India celebrates a number of different festivals throughout the year. One such event is the Islamic festival of Eid-ul-Fitr, which is celebrated by Muslims with great fervor, not only in India, but all across the world. This year, due to the coronavirus pandemic, the festival was kept a low-key affair in the country. The month of Ramadan brings with itself teachings of self-discipline, sacrifice and control. Observed for a span of 30 days, the Islamic festival is not only celebrated with great fervor and enthusiasm in India, but also around the world. Just like the beginning of Ramadan, the religious month ends with the first sighting of a new moon marked as the festival of Eid-ul-Fitr. Every year, the festival of Eid-ul-Fitr, commonly known as Eid, is celebrated with zeal and colour in different cities of India, but this year, the festival was kept a low-key affair in the wake of the resurgence of COVID-19 cases. While most of the places remain deserted due to imposed lockdowns, mosques in some cities such as Amritsar and Agartala opened for devotees to offer prayers with heavy security and proper adherence to COVID-19 SOPs.
ये ईद उल फितर जो हम मनाते हैं ये एक साल के अंदर जो हम 30 रोजे रखते हैं उसके बाद हम खुशी के साथ ईद उल फितर मनाते हैं लेकिन इस बार जो ईद का त्यौहार है बहुत ही सादगी के साथ बनाया गया जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं जामा मस्जिद में बहुत ही ज्यादा तादाद में लोग आते थे लेकिन कोरोना को लेते हुए अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह हमने डिस्टेंसिंग का पालन किया और बहुत ही कम तादाद में हमारे आसपास के मोहल्ले के लोगों ने ईद की नमाज अदा करी.
As the month of Ramadan calls for rigorous fasting during the daytime, with the belief that it will bring devotees closer to God, the last day of the month goes by the name of Eid-ul-Fitr, which translates to the festival of breaking the fast. Due to the second wave of the coronavirus pandemic, devotees had to mark the festival amid COVID restrictions. Islamic organization urged Muslims all over the country to stay indoors and offer prayers at home during the time of the festival.
और इस्लामिक सेंटर ऑफ इंडिया ने जो अपील की थी कि लोग कहीं पर भी लोग पास से ज्यादा जमा होकर नमाज ना अदा करें तो अच्छी बात यह है कि सब लोगों ने उस पर अमल किया है और लोग घरों ही में ईद मना रहे हैं और अगर हम लोग इस तरीके के प्रिकॉशन बड़े पैमाने पर कुछ दिन और ले लें लेते रहेंगे तो इंशाल्लाह जल्दी ही इस बीमारी से निजात सबको हासिल हो जाएगी और फिर नमाज के बाद अल्लाह से ये दुआ की गई कि अल्लाह हमारे मुल्क से और पूरी दुनिया से इस कोरोना वायरस का हमेशा हमेशा के लिए खात्मा फरमा दे.
Shops in northern cities of Lucknow and Varanasi were shut due to the strict restrictions imposed by the authorities. New Delhi's iconic Jama Mosque was also under heavy security on the festival to avoid further spread of the virus.
हमने पिछले साल की तरह हमने इस साल भी हमने काफी पुख्ता इंतजाम किए गए हैं, काफी फोर्स डिप्लाई की हमने, साथ ही साथ हमने प्रोएक्टिवली हमने मौजूद लोगों से बातचीत करके हमने कोशिश की है कि सभी लोग अपने घरों पे रहें, सभी लोग अपने घरों पे नमाज अदा करें. सबको मैं ईद की हार्दिक बधाई देना चाहूंगा.
Meanwhile, in some of the cities, local administrations had allowed a four-hour break from the lockdown for people to step outside of their homes for Eid shopping and prayers. The resurgence of COVID-19 cases in the country has posed a number of challenges in front of the entire country, with the authorities leaving no stone unturned in its efforts to curb the virus spread. Citizens' organizations and religious institutions are also doing their best to provide their services to the needy. Recently, a mosque in the capital city of New Delhi has been converted into a temporary COVID-19 facility.
In desperate times like these of the pandemic, it becomes very important for all citizens to join hands together and take measures to help those who are needy and destitute. While a number of individuals and organizations have stepped up to distribute free meals, NGOs and religious organizations are taking out sanitization drives and arranging oxygen cylinders for the needy. Citing an example of religious harmony and contributing to the cause, a mosque in New Delhi city has been converted into a COVID-19 quarantine center where citizens, regardless of their caste, religion, and socio-economic backgrounds, can be quarantined.
ये हमने कोविड आइसोलेट सेंटर खोला है और इसमें सिर्फ मेडिसिन्स का हमने अरेंजमेंट रखा है आइसोलेट करने के लिए और इसके अलावा अभी तक जो इंक्वायरीज आई हैं हमारे पास वो ऑक्सीजन वाली आई हैं और वो हमारा सेंटर नहीं है तो फिलहाल हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि अगर कोई आता है तो उनके लिए भी वो अरेंजमेंट किया जाए.
Located in the Green Park area of the capital city, this mosque is therefore called as the Green Park Mosque by locals. Currently, this quarantine center is equipped with 10 beds and all medical facilities. Patients will be provided with masks, sanitizers, and medicines, along with free meals 3 times a day.
ग्लव्स हैं, पीपी किट्स हैं और सारे सैनिटाइजर सिस्टम हैं, वो हमने सारा अरेंजमेंट रखा हुआ अपने पास. तो अभी फ़िलहाल इंक्वायरीज चल रही हैं, हमारे पास मैसेजेस हमारे पास आ रहे हैं, फ़ोन्स आ रहे हैं और हम उनको बताते हैं कि हमारे पास बेड अवेलेबल है, मेडिसिन अवेलेबल है और आपका जो डिस्क्रिप्शन है डॉक्टर्स का, हम उस पर आपको चीज़ें दे सकते हैं, प्रोवाइड कर सकते हैं. खाना, लंच, ब्रेकफास्ट और डिनर वो हमारी तरफ से प्रोवाइड किया जाएगा.
सिमिलरली, टेंपल्स, गुरुद्वारास एंड अदर रिलीजियस प्लेसेस आर आल्सो मेकिंग अरेंजमेंट्स एंड टेकिंग स्टेप्स टू हेल्प द नीडी अमिड द पैंडेमिक एंड सर्व अ ग्रेटर कॉज.
नाउ अ राउंड अप ऑफ सम ऑफ द मेजर स्टोरीज दैट मेड न्यूज रिसेंटली.
India began a pilot program for Russia's Sputnik V COVID-19 vaccine on Monday to work out supply chain and logistical needs for distribution across the nation. Sputnik V is a two-dose shot that has been found to be 91.6% effective in preventing people from developing coronavirus, a higher efficacy rate than the two vaccines currently approved in India. CEO of Dr. Reddy's Labs, the company overseeing the program, Deepak Sabra, said, by carrying out this program, they will learn enough to be able to scale it up across the country.
We are running the pilot with a few people. By doing so, we will be able to establish the integrity of the supply chain. We'll be able to see how the cold chain works. We'll be able to see how the logistics work. And by doing this, we will be able to make sure that we have enough learning so that we can scale it up across the country.
India received 60,000 doses of Sputnik V from Russia as part of its second consignment of the vaccine. A miniature artist in the city of Chandigarh has created an artwork to convey the message of keeping a positive attitude during these pandemic times. Balraj Singh used pieces of chalk to carve the words "Get vaccinated, be safe" to motivate common folks to get vaccination done.
जो आज ये दौर एक कोविड-19 की वजह से चल रहा है, उसमें कहीं एक हमें पॉजिटिव जो एक चीज़ दिखाई दे रही है वैक्सीनेशन के ज़रिए, उसमें ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोग पार्टिसिपेट करें और वैक्सीनेशन करवाएं जाके, क्योंकि एक हर तरफ एक नेगेटिविटी फैली हुई है और कहीं एक जो पॉजिटिव चीज़ हमें दिख रही है उसकी तरफ ज़रूर जाना चाहिए. तो मेरा मैसेज सबके लिए अपनी आर्ट के ज़रिए के ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोग जाके वैक्सीनेशन करवाएं.
His creative artwork is being appreciated by many.
As India's second wave of COVID-19 continues to pose various challenges to people, Mumbai's famous dabbawalas or tiffin carriers have been reaching out to those in need by providing free food at hospitals and COVID centers. Take a look.
In the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, individuals and organizations all over the country are offering their services to provide free meals to those in need. An important name in this list is of the Mumbai's famed dabbawalas or tiffin service providers. Dressed in a white outfit and traditional Gandhi cap, these groups of dabbawalas have been distributing food items amid COVID-19 pandemic.
हम में से ही कुछ दबे वाले लोग कंट्रीब्यूट करते हैं और ट्रस्ट के माध्यम से भी कुछ पैसा आता है तो उसका ही भले सिचुएशन कुछ भी हो हमारी मगर मानवता जीवित रहनी चाहिए वही उद्देश्य लेकर उद्देश्य से हम लोग एक काम कर रहे हैं
The Dabbawalas are delivery men from rural Mumbai, known for their impeccable distribution management system. They have been distributing food to the attendees outside hospitals as well as COVID centers, irrespective of caste, creed or religion. Taking all necessary precautions, strict social distancing protocols are being followed by the distributors to curb the virus spread. As many restaurants and dhabas were closed due to lockdown, relatives and friends of admitted patients in the hospital expressed their appreciation to the trust for their humanitarian provision.
लॉकडाउन दोबारा शुरू हुआ था तो हम लोग को खाना मतलब खरीद के खाने में बहुत तकलीफ हो रही थी होटल होटल सारे बंद रह रहे थे अधिकतर समय तो ये लोग खाना जो देते थे बहुत बढ़िया खाना देते थे और इससे हमारे पेट भी भरते थे और पैसा भी नहीं लगता था पैसा भी बचता था इलाज में जो पैसा बचता था उससे हम इलाज में लगाते थे
मदद तो सर काफ़ी होती है जैसे अगर बाहर से खाना हम लेते तो 150-100 रुपीज़ के रेंज में नॉर्मल खाना मिलता है वो भी मतलब प्योर नहीं होता नॉर्मल कोई भी तेल में किसी भी चीज़ में बना के देते तो दोनों टाइम का मिला के चलो तो 300 पकड़ लो तो 300 वन डे के भी बचना काफ़ी है और फिर प्लस पानी की बॉटल भी ये लोग जो दे रहे हैं उसके लिए भी बहुत हेल्प होती है बाहर से 20 रुपीस की एक मिलती है
कॉमनर्स ऑल ओवर द कंट्री आर डूइंग देयर लेवल बेस्ट टू हेल्प द अथॉरिटीज इन ऑल पॉसिबल वेज इन फाइटिंग द डेडली कोरोना वायरस
Considering the risk of airborne transmission of COVID-19 virus mutant, a youngster from Hyderabad city of Telangana has come up with an innovative electric nebulizer mask which can be worn while on move also. Have a look. Protecting the respiratory system has become one of the prime necessities during this unprecedented time of the COVID-19 pandemic. Realizing the dire need to keep the lungs and immune system healthy, a 24-year-old Telangana's Shiva Nagaruja from Deshmukhi village has created an innovative electric nebulizer mask. Son of a farmer, Shiva, who is a BCom computer student, is passionate about electronics but could not opt for BTech due to financial constraints. Nevertheless, it did not deter Shiva from inventing new products. After working for a month, Shiva and his team developed this portable electric mask.
I made an electrical mask. In the pandemic situation, me and myself, we sat together and we think overall almost 1 month about this project. And we made a new decision to make a home nebulization process. And actually we named it for electrical mask. And we made an electrical mask. Absolutely, it is very useful in the present situation.
मैं इस टाइम पे 6 महीना से काम कर रहा हूँ मेरा डिजिग्नेशन डिज़ाइनर है जनरल मास्क में एयर फिल्टर करता है इलेक्ट्रिकल मास्क में एयर प्योरीफायर करता है इसलिए इस टाइम पे एयर प्योरीफायर मास्क ज़रूरत होती है
Nebulizer machines are electric devices that turn liquid medicine into a fine mist. The mist then travels down a tube and comes out through a mouthpiece or mask. This mask has a direct current motor, circuits of recharge module,
air filter, and if charged, the battery backup can run up to 3 hours. Apart from the present cloth mask which is attached to it, the nebulizer weighs 400 grams and is 10 centimeters in length and 4 centimeters in width. The creator says that this unique and affordable mask can be easily used while on the move and is handy.
It is very cheap, although it is an electronic device. We are going to provide for 600 to 700. So actually we are planning for that. We got a patent for this project and our team registration also is completed and we are looking for sponsorship and investment. Once the government or private sectors, if they support us, definitely we'll take to the market. Using our mask, it will take the air from one chamber and it will filter in the other chamber and it will go for the medicine chamber. Then it will mix the medicine inside the chamber and it will come through a small pipe to the mask which we are holding. So that the air is filtering almost 3 times. So definitely the dust particles will separate. And the medicine and the air will mix together and will come to the nose.
Shiva says he now aspires to expand his innovation and take technology into a new era to help society create a healthy lifestyle.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section, World in Focus.
This is Kamon, a Japanese crest inspired from a form of plant or geometric shape. In the samurai era, Kamon was used to distinguish between friends and enemies during battle. Slowly and steadily, it became a cultural component that preserves the history of Japanese families and expresses their ancient roots. Since the 10th century in Japan, Kamon is being used as a family crest that distinguishes between the prince and samurai family. It was painted during the battles on the cloth war flag known as Hata. During the Edo period, the use of Kamon has spread among the commoners as well. In Japan, about 50,000 of these Kamons or emblems can still be spotted in an old district in Tokyo. However, they no longer refer to a family of prince or a warrior, but rather to the owner of a restaurant or shop.
現在の日本でのカモンの使われ方っていうのは、冠婚葬祭 って呼ばれる、その行事事ですよね。の時ぐらいでしか、見られないっていうことが多いです。特に、結婚式であったりとか、あとお葬式の時には家紋をつけるっていうのがやっぱあるんですけれども、ただ、それも、その文化そのものがどんどんやっぱ廃れてきてるっていうか、だから、 それまで日本が築き上げてきたその家紋を使うっていう文化っていうそのものは徐々に徐々に減ってきてます。The
designs of kamon are inspired by geometric shapes or a plant that is known to rapidly grow and spread, indicating the power and strength of the family and optimism for their expansion and survival for long generations. It is a symbol that symbolizes long roots of families and expresses its history, which is why Japanese citizens consider it a very important component of their culture. This Japanese sword is called katana. It is a traditional sword with an elaborate blade. An ornament or detail, most of its parts are handmade. This sword is a weapon which was used in samurai war years ago. These craftsmen have been making katana for the last 22 years after getting trained from a sword craft master. The blade of the sword extends to a stage and the hot iron is hammered. It takes 3 months to make one of these swords.
Japan独特の技術によって 作られて、それでその武器でありながら、その美術的価値が認められているっていうのは世界で唯一の武器だと思います。
そういった形でものすごく希少性があるということが一つだと思います。その日本の鉄というのはものすごく高いんですよね。その完成品としてできたものというものは、まあ、ものによってですけれども、美術性の高いもの、評価されたものというものは、国宝級でやはり億という値段がつきます。おそらく世界どこ見ても、それだけの値段つく武器はないと思います。
This shop in Tokyo sells Japanese sword. These craftsmen have the permission from the government to make the swords. The Japanese sword is made by highly skilled craftsmen, which is being reflected through its high artistic value. The spirit of traditional Japanese manufacturing is admired by the world. Marking the International Day of Light, an artist illuminated the alpine city of Bressan with encouraging messages. Petra Poli chose to set up positive words and messages in six languages such as transform, develop, mature, and life wants to be moved in central parts of the city.
Das Thema hat mich insofern fasziniert, weil es in den Medien immer wieder ständig Veränderungen gab. Veränderungen in den Öffnungszeiten, Veränderungen in den Schließungen. Also alles Corona-bedingt, die ganzen Veränderungen. Insofern war dieses Thema sehr, sehr präsent. Das Einzige, was mich an diesem Ganzen extrem gestört hat, war der negative Aspekt.
Poli said she found the constant negative talk about change challenging and searched to find the right positive words associated with change. Curator Stephanie Preet said the pandemic was an individual challenge to people all over the world and she hoped people would be inspired by the light arts positive message.
E credo proprio che il segreto dell'arte stia nel dialogare direttamente con lo spettatore. Infatti ci sono molteplici significati che stanno dietro a quest'opera e quindi ognuno di noi può capire e interpretare qualcosa di diverso.
A zoo in the Peruvian capital Lima is thrilled to present two endangered baby American crocodiles to the public who were born at the zoo in February through artificial insemination. Zookeepers at the Ho Chi Pa Zoo say the two crocs, which at 3 months and 10 days old, who now measure 26 centimeters in length, are doing well after their eggs hatched in January. The crocodile eggs were incubated for 90 days and were the only surviving two out of a total of 24 eggs. It is still too early to determine the sex of the two newborns, but proud parents Coco and La Pinta, who also live at the zoo, can expect to be united with their offspring once they get stronger. The American crocodile, which can grow up to 4.8 meters, are shy and reclusive, experts say, and feed mostly between dusk and dawn. Crocodiles are still classified as an endangered species, although the numbers of the large reptiles have rebounded in some parts of the world, such as South Florida in the United States. The American crocodile can be found in countries including Mexico, Venezuela, Peru, Ecuador, and the United States.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Karim Zimik, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.